proper knowledge in which the fire of yagya service is lit. It is like the fire is lit, and anything impure gold is kept in that fire, the alloy is burned and the shine comes out. So in this, in which the fire of yagya service is lit, yagya service means serving others also, inspiring others to purify their lives, to give them this realization also that now time is changing. So that is yagya service, service done for the purification process in the name of purifying others also and the self also. The light of the intellect is shining like the sun, and there are no clouds of attachment in the sky of the heart. The heart is like the sky. So such beautiful description is given how the light is lit and the intellect is starting to shine like the sun. There are no clouds of attachment in the sky of the heart, and there is complete brightness of feelings. This is the path of light. The soul who leaves the body at a very auspicious moment, at the right time of such a day, on a bright fortnight of a lunar month, that is Shukla Paksh, and when the sun moves northwards, Uttarayan, that one achieves elevated salvation. Means he directly goes to Paramdham, northward direction. So Uttarayan Disha. So northward direction means Paramdham, directly to that home. On the fortnight of a lunar month, bright fortnight of a lunar month means they have purified themselves and they have reached that brightness, that 16 celestial degrees of the lunar month means the night of Brahma. So night of Brahma in the Uttarayan northward direction, that is towards Paramdham, and achieves elevated salvation. So this is the significance. This, we have been reading this word so many times but hardly realized. And whatever is opposite to this is the path of darkness, which I have not mentioned here in the form of slide, because we are here to inspire you to go through the path of light only. So let that be clear in your mind so that the confusion is not there. If I would describe that path of darkness also, after you go from here, sometimes there is confusion. The thoughts are such, they start getting mixed with one another. So I'm not telling the path of darkness here. If you feel like reading it, go to the Gita also and you'll understand. But don't try to confuse your mind. Only keep your mind, if you have this aim, I want to go through the path of light, then this is the clarification. So this is the path of light, which means you get eternal salvation, elevated salvation. And as the Kriti Yuga starts, the golden dawn of Satyuga starts, immediately you come down in the heavenly period. God made man in his own image. And then tomorrow, we'll be seeing the further chapters. Chapter 9. The deep yoga and the skill to rule the kingdom. Self-sovereignty. How can we rule our own kingdom? So tomorrow will be 9th chapter, which will also be very interesting. And as God today explained, Jnana Vijnana of the eternal cycle, the nature, the supreme abode, so many clarifications were done in today's chapters. And this is how, if we really become self-realized souls, will definitely go on towards that path. And that will be our fortune. That is the highest fortune that God has come to grant us. And He wants each and every child of His to go through the path of light. Such merciful he is, such benefactor he is, and he loves each and every one of his child, and this is why he wants you to be that part of that divine kingdom. That's why I said in the morning also, either you are a part of the problem or you are a part of the solution. Either you are a part of construction or you are a part of destruction. Either you are a path of light, you follow the path of light, or you follow the path of darkness. It is up to us which path we would like to follow. Okay? So with this, for a few moments we shall sit in meditation. And as his eternal form is clarified in each chapters gradually, how is the sukshmate sukshma? So for a few moments we become soul conscious, forgetting that I am this body, I am so and so, I have this name, I have this, forget all that. I have this bodily relations and this is the task I am doing, forget all that. I am a soul, a point of light stabilized in the center of the forehead, who is the master of all senses. So stabilize in the soul conscious stage, and then you can see how naturally we start to elevate and fly towards the Supreme Being. Be under his canopy. Stabilize there in his company. Be in the company of God and just feel God's love. So today we shall have a meditation based on what God has taught us, how to stabilize ourselves in that consciousness of soul. Okay? So for a few moments, let us turn our attention. Away from the physical world, the materialistic world, and just be present here. In the consciousness that I am a soul. This body is like my temple. And I am the conscient, self-luminous entity in this temple. I am the master of the senses. As I focus my attention in the center of the forehead, which is my throne, where I sit and control the body and the actions, as I stabilize myself in the consciousness of the attributes of the soul, I feel so light within. I become free from all the bondages of attachments. I become light and experience no burdens. Experience complete freedom. And slowly and gradually, I start ascending. From this world of physical nature, from this world of five elements, I still ascend completely free, embodiment of light. And I travel through the sun, moon and stars and still ascend, cross the subtle region and enter the divine Brahma element, which is the highest abode. Which is the abode of liberation. And with my mind's eye, I visualize myself in a completely liberated form, the embodiment of light. As I see myself in this divine element, it is so peaceful, the abode of silence. Slowly and gradually, I move forward towards my Supreme Father. And as I am a point of light, He is also the subtlest of the subtle. Infinite in His